Hi guys, JC Little here in the studio. A lot of you guys know me as a digital artist and, animator and blogging cartoons and stuff like that. But the truth is that I do actually do more traditional kind of fine art stuff, watercolor. And I recently got sort of brave and went out and started doing Pleinair painting, which basically means you go out and into the wide world and paint whatever you see out there. So my thing is that I do this kind of thing while I'm walking my dog, Chuck.
Hi, Chuck.
So if it doesn't fit in my dog walking bag, then I don't take it. So in here I have, this is my full kit. This is it, just this. So what do we have here? This is my basic kit. So this is like a rag, which is basically one of those bar cloths. I cut them in four so they'd be smaller. They're really useful. I actually like them better than tissues. Tissues are great, but when you're outside, the wind does tend to pick them up and like, woo, fly them off. And that's no good, is it? You need everything to be really stable and sticking around. So I use these cloths and I find them really great. And after a while, they get all these pretty colors on them. Even after you wash them, the colors stay, and that's kind of fun. All right, let me take this all apart for you. So my basic kit has this Perspex board. I'm calling it a board, but is it a board, actually? It's a board. I mean, it's one of those replacement Perspex sheets to replace a frame that has broken its glass, you know, like a photo frame or something like that. So this is really thin. It's so light. I filed down the edges with some sandpaper because the edges on these are pretty sharp. So these are not expensive. I think this particular one is 6x4, 4x6, yeah. And you can get them in different sizes. You know, this one fits, as you saw, really neatly into the back of my bag here. Woo! So this is great. I got this elastic thing from arttoolkit.com. They have great stuff for expeditionary artists, and I think that being a dog walk painter qualifies me as an expeditionary artist. I know I'm not going to Alaska or painting, walruses, or even, you know, painting from hanging from a hang glider or a helicopter or anything like that. But hey, dog walking. And when you got a really big dog and he just lays down beside the park bench, then I think that qualifies as an expeditionary artist. So these are great to hold things against your board. Fantastic. I use this very tiny little ZigZag palette. I also got them from Expeditionary Art. They're made by Hahnemüehle. They're called the Hahnemüehle ZigZag Sketchbook, watercolor sketchbook. So these are great. They're only 2x2 inches. And there's watercolor paper in there. They're super small, super lightweight. And, you know, if you just want to keep your plein air muscles, you know, in shape every day, do a little quick sketch. It doesn't take long to fill up that tiny little surface area. So that's quite fun. Go with that. And this, of course, is the Art Toolkit's own Demi palette that has these tiny little, tiny little, everything's tiny and little. You can see there's some, I don't know if you can see, but there's actually some dog hair in there in the paint. Sorry, but that's what happens when you're the expeditionary artist type. Dog walk painter. So these are metal. I have the colors written on the back. Thalo blue green. This is actually the split primary palette. There's a mixing area here, a mixing tray. I also have an extra mixing tray that's, you know, that these guys, Art Toolkit, speaking of dog hair, they sell these as well. So I put a little bit of Jane's Gray in there, just because I could probably mix it. I mean, I can mix it from these colors, but it's just it takes too long, and you know, getting the balance exactly right is just quicker. So I just squirted some in here, and it dries, and I use it just like that. So this is useful, and how I put this all together is with these fantastic magnets. So I'm going to show you how I do this. So I go out. Then I take it out of my bag, and then I put this magnet here, this, and I put this magnet here. These two magnets are humping each other. Put this magnet here, and then I put this mixing tray here. Put this like so. Okay. This magnet goes here. Then I get my super fantastic, let's say I'm going to, you know, do a painting. So I put it on here like this, stick it there, and then I have my water. Now, because these are magnets, I tried all of these different ways of carrying water with me. I don't want to carry a lot of water because, like I said before, I'm a total weakling. It just hurts my back to carry a lot of heavy things. So I don't want to carry like a big bottle of water. So I want to bring a small amount of water. And actually, you don't need a lot of water when you're out painting watercolor. You know, it's amazing how little water you need. So I tried other things like this that clip on. But I mean, honestly, you know, clipping this on here, it's really bulky and heavy. You know, I tried this one too. It leaks. Actually, these both leak. Terrible. This is not even magnetic. This is the water, the whiskey painter. Anyways, I just put all that away, and I went, huh, I've got these little medication bottles. You know, why don't I, here's one I prepared earlier. Why don't I show you guys how I did this? I just put a quarter. Yes, Canadian money is magnetic. So I put this Canadian quarter in the bottom and filled it up with water, and voila. So I just take the lid off, be very careful not to spill any water on my beautiful painting that I already painted in. And there you go, ready to paint. Oh, brushes, of course, brushes. This is my favorite plein air brush. It's a Red Dot Rosemary and Co. I also ordered this through arttoolkit.com. I love those guys. I really love their stuff. It suits me perfectly, as you can see, for this lightweight dog walking plein air painter kit. And this is the Red Dot. I think it's number 4. I like this brush because it's soft, it's flat, it's long, and so it has a lot of give in it. So I can use it for a lot of different things. And then I have, you know, your standard silver black velvet travel water brush. And this is a number 4. And so I use this for just some details. I personally don't see, very well when can't see. I'm totally blind when I go out painting. I don't know what I'm doing. No, because I'm painting stuff that's pretty far away. Sometimes it's way across on the other side of the pond. This particular book is tree trunks. But, you know, often what I'm painting is really pretty far away, so I can't see any details. And I also, I don't have my glasses, so I can't see, you know, what I'm painting. And I'm using a pretty big brush. And you know, I sometimes use this smaller brush for the tree branches and stuff like that. But basically, I can't see because I don't have my glasses, and I don't want to mess around with glasses when I'm out painting in the world. You know, looking up over my glasses and then down through my glasses, you know, forget that. So I usually just save all the like heavy detail painting for when I get home. Da, 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 painty, painty, painty. Now, you know, why even bother having this on here, okay? I will tell you, is because I don't want to have to, like reach down somewhere beside me on the park bench to get my water, you know? I just want it to be like right there. I want everything to be really close to what I'm painting. So there you have it. There's my basic kit. I do also use this kit for when I use a watercolor block, which is basically like this, one of these. This is really good Fabriano Artistico paper. So I just throw that under there like that, and then I do my painting. I do have to hold it, but normally when I'm sitting on a park bench, you know, I've got to be comfortable because I am of a certain age. I put this bag on my lap, and you know, with every dog thing, paraphernalia that's in here, it raises it up on my lap enough that it doesn't hurt my neck. You know, my neck doesn't have to like bend all the way down to see or not see because I'm blind. You know, what I'm doing on the paper. So this is really good. And sometimes I can really just leave it there and just hold it on the side like this. La, 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 painty, painty. Let's just pack it all up and put it all away. I hope you enjoyed this little video. I did wash this bag just for this filming episode, okay? So you should appreciate that. That's how nice I am. I am nice because, I mean, my dog, he slobbers a lot. So use your own bag. I'm sure you can, you know, figure that out. Thanks for watching. I hope this was useful. Okay, bye.